Hi everyone, welcome you all. In this video, I'm going to show you how to send put request using RestAssured automation. So to demonstrate this, I'm just taking this particular API URL, and in this particular URL, we can just create a new employee record, or we can update the existing record, or we can delete the existing record. So multiple operations we can perform. So let me just show you how we can use this API using Postman, and then we'll come back to the RestAssured automation. So let's go to your Postman. So the same API request, and here I'm passing employees as a path parameter. It will give you, or when I send this request, it will give you the all the employees details which are already there in my database. So these are the employee details which are already there in my database. Suppose I want to get the data of a specific employee, we need to pass the employee ID, and then we need to raise one more get request. So for example, I'm just taking this ID 1108. I'm just sending one more request, same URL, and here I'm passing the employee ID as a parameter. This is also get request. So this particular API will give you information about this particular record or employee. So when I send this request, it will give you the data. So this is ID. For this ID, the employee name is Roche, and salary is this one, age is this one, and profile image. So this is the data, we got it. So now I'm going to update this existing record by using put action. So to send the put action, I have created one more request. So here I've taken as a put action, but the same employee ID we have to specify. So 1108 my ID. So I'm passing 1108, and this will basically update the existing record. But previously, what is the data we have is employee name is Roche, and salary is something, and age is 29. So now when you send the put request, also we need to send the body. So I'll set the body and raw data in JSON format, and the name is equal to John 1234, and salary is something I selected, and age also selected. So I'm passing this particular body as part of put request, because it will go and update the existing data based on the employee ID. Now, when I send this put request, click on the send, it will go and update the record. So now we got the updated data. So again, if you go back and get the data, updated data for this particular employee ID, now we can see the updated data here. Okay, so this is called as a put request. So now I'm going to show you the same kind of operation using RestAssured automation. Now let's go to Eclipse. So here in the last session, we have created a new project, RestAssured API testing BDD project, and also we have seen how to perform get and post request. Now I'm going to show you how we can update the record, that is your put request. So let's create a new class, and here I will just create a demo 3 underscore put underscore request. All right, so now main method, no, don't take main method because we are using testing features. All right, so now here I will create a first method where I can specify the body of the request, because I need to update the data, right? So we need to specify the updated data. For that, I will create one method, test method. Let's say public void put data. So this is the data we need to update. So here I will specify the data, and I'll specify this as a before class annotation, because this method I want to execute before actual test is present. So inside this, I will specify the body of the response. In the Postman, when you see here, when I send my updated request, I'll specify some body, right? The name and salary and age. So we need this kind of data, which is part of request payload. Now I will store this data in hash map, Java hash map. So for that, I will create one hash map variable as a global variable. So here I'll say public. Right, so I'll make it as a static variable. So public static and hash map, and I'll create one map variable. Let's say map is equal to new hash map. I just created one hash map variable and import this hash map from java.utils package. So now we need to prepare the data, right? So we need to pass the data, but where we can generate this data. So we already have restutils.java. So because instead of hard coding the data, I'm dynamically generating the data. So here, if you see here, I have created a few number of methods, EMP name, EMP salary, and EMP age. So when I call this particular method, it will generate the random employee names and random salaries and random ages. So here I created some method called random string utils dot random numeric. So this and random string dot random alphabetic. So when I say alphabetic here, this will create a string type of data, and here it will create a number type of data. Okay. So now I'll call these two methods, these three methods, EMP name, EMP salary, EMP age. This will give you the dynamic values every time instead of hard coding the data. So how we can call these methods? So RestUtils is a static class. So RestUtils is a direct class, and every method is a static method so that we can call those methods directly by using class name. So before, after specifying the hash map here from the RestUtils, so I will just call a method called EMP name, because RestUtils we need to import properly. Let me write properly here. So the class name is RestUtils, right? So RestUtils dot. So it's not properly giving. Let's see what is an error. So we need to import this class first of all. So let's try to import. So we no need to import because this is there in the same class. RestAssuredTest, right? So let me just write one more time. So I'll say RestUtils dot. So what is the name of the method here is the RestUtils. So we have EMP name, right? So let me just call this method EMP name. So this will give you the name exactly. So we need to store that into a variable. So let's take a string EMP name. So EMP name. I'm storing this value into variable. So now the RestAssured is not giving any error. So because this class is present inside the same package, we no need to import that package. So directly we call the EMP name. And similarly, I will call other methods. The other method we have here is, so other method here we have is EMP salary. So I'm also getting the EMP salary here. And this is our another variable. This is, I'll say EMP salary. And I will also call another method from the RestUtils, so that is your EMP age. So I'm just replacing with EMP age, and this is your employee age value. All right, so now I captured the three different values dynamically from the RestUtils.java method. So Java class here, I have created methods which will generate dynamically EMP names, salaries, and employee ages. Every time when you run your code, you will get the updated data or new data, or else we need to hard code the data here. Because once we have hardcoded the data, next time the data will be changed when you run your test case, right? So I'm just taking this data. Now we need to pass this data as part of your put request, because all the existing data is available, but we need to update the data with the new data. So this is how we need to get the values, and we need also employee ID. So I'm creating a simple variable called EMP underscore ID. This ID should be existing ID. So in the Postman, we need to first to send all employees data request and get the ID, which is existing record. So someone, so for example, I am getting some of the employee ID. So let's pick it up. For example, let me just take this one, 11254. Okay. So for now, I'm just taking this particular ID. This is an integer thing. Okay. So with this particular ID, whoever is having this particular ID, that employee data, I want to modify it by using put request. So now here we need to create one hash map variable. So we already created map variable. So now we need to add all this data to the map. So map dot put. So here we need to specify map dot put. Let me just say map dot. So map dot put. So here we need to specify the, what is the first field is name. So there's a first field. So when I say here, a name, employee salary, and employee age is there, right? So the first field I'll say name, and comma, from where we need to get this name, from here, right? So we can also specify EMP name directly here, right? So the otherwise we can also call this RestUtils.emp name directly here. That is also fine. So if you still don't want to create this method separately, we can directly use RestUtils.emp name directly here. So now I'm specifying this EMP name, right? So similarly, I will also add other values here. So map.putName is there. So the next value is salary. I'll say salary is equal to, so this is my EMP salary I captured from RestUtils. And then the next one is age. So here I am passing the EMP age, right? So this is the data we need to pass, name, salary, and age. Now here we need to also specify the BSURN path. So here I'll say RestAssured dot base URI, right? So base URI is equal to, in the double quotations, so whatever base URI we are using, this is the one. So let me copy this and paste it over here and then semicolon. So we need to import this RestAssured from io.RestAssured. So this is our base URI. So we need to give properly. So this is base URI. So dot base URI, right? And also we need to specify the base path. So RestAssured dot base path. So this is your base path. So base path is, if you want to update any record, we need to send a put request by adding update dot EMP ID. So update slash here, we need to pass a employee ID. So what I'm going to do here is I am just updating or appending the EMP ID, whichever I configured here. So every time you need to pass a EMP ID as part of the base path. So is equal to, okay. So this is my base path. Along with this URI, we need to also specify this path parameter update along with the employee ID. And then it will go and update the record. So now we need to send the body also along with the request. We need to send a put request along with this particular body. So let me write one more method here. That is public void. Void test data or public void test put. Okay, so test put request. So here, first of all, I'll use a given keyword. We need to start with the given. So here we need to specify the, whenever you use put request or post request, in these two cases we need to specify the content type. So in the given, we need to specify the content type, body, all these things. But before that, we need to import proper packages. So what are the packages? Static package we need to import. So the static package we use, we need to import is this one. So import static.io /.star. So this will import all the packages from RestAssured. So this is your static package which we need to import, and then these keywords will be identified. So now under given keyword, we need to specify the prerequisites. So what are those prerequisites? The first one is a content type we need to specify, especially when you send your post request or put request. So here I'll say content type, and content type is a JSON format. I'm saying application slash JSON. Okay, JSON format I'm sending. And the next one is dot body also we need to pass. So what is the body we are passing? The map, whichever map we created above, that map, because this contains the name, salary, and age. So after sending this, these are the two prerequisites. And after sending this, then when. So here we need to send a request under when section. So these are the prerequisites. And then under when section, we need to send the request. What kind of request? We need to send a put request. So here we no need to specify any URL. By default, these things will be sent. And after sending the post request, then we need to perform the validation. So after sending this request, what is the status code we should get? Suppose if you have updated the record, the status code should be 200. So that we need to verify. So dot status code should be 200. So this is my last statement. So end with the semicolon. So every time the last statement should end with the semicolon. So in the given session, we specified the prerequisites, that is our content type and body of the request. And in the when section, I say put, that is actual request. And in the then section, I specified the status code. So this is actual test. So I'll specify with @test annotation and import that from test ng annotation, right? So this is how we need to send a put request. So first, what I have done is I captured EMP name, salary, age data from the RestUtils, because there are predefined methods I created in under the RestUtils. So I'm just calling those methods to generate the data dynamically. And EMP name, salary, age, I'm passing as a body. And here EMP ID we need to specify, because this ID should be present in the database and some record already existing. And that existing data record we need to update. right? So now I'm sending this request along with this particular data. Now let us execute and see how this is going to work. So right click, run as test ninja test. So now I have executed. So once I have executed, now we can see my test should pass. So now we can see my test is got passed. So because this is exactly updated the record. Okay, so this is how we can get the data. We can update the data. Fine. So suppose if you want to see whether it's updated or not properly, we can add one more statement here, log dot all. So this particular command will log all the statements, whatever data is updated. So this time I will give a different employee ID. So let me send this all the data request. Now I'm taking one of the employee ID. Let us take, so one of the employee ID, some of the employee IDs doesn't have any data. So I'm just taking 11501. So currently we have a Sashi, right? So I'm just sending here because I want to see what is the data we have for this employee ID. So currently the ID is this one. Sashi is there and 1025 is the age. So I'm using the same ID now. So I'm just go and update here. Now I'm going to update the same record. So this time again, we'll get the new data set and we'll send the same data as part of put request and update the data. And this time we will get the log also. What exactly data is updated data. So let me execute this code. Run as testing the test one more time. So now it is sending a request. Done. So it is passed. Now if you observe here, it will give you exactly what is the content. So it is returning the server date, content type, transfer encoding, connection, all these things. And finally, it is also giving the response here. So name is equal to John B, salary is this one, age is this one. But previously that data is different. So in the postman, we have seen this data, right? So Sashi is there, 1000. Again, if you send the same request in the postman, so you can see the updated data. So the same thing, it is displayed in the console window as an output. So when I say this particular statement, log dot all, so this will give you exact response, complete response from that particular API. So this is how we need to send a put request to the REST API. We can update the existing record in the database. Okay. So that's all for put request. In the next video, we'll see the rest of the things.